Say hi to everybody. Where we at?
She.
Yeah, baby.
Sexual Health Expo.
We're at the Sexual Health Expo here in LA. In case you wondered. My love?
Can they hear us?
Holly, Terry, Andrea, what's up? We're here with Desire. We're going to broadcast from the Sexual Health Expo. What's up, Chris and Adi?
Flex when I do that. I'm gonna flex. Oh,
that way. We're going to start doing this here. We talked about it. We're going to be launching it soon, our Triple T seminars. This is a place we've been asked to speak. I spoke here last year, unfortunately. This year, it didn't really work into our schedule. But we talked about how it's time to touch. We talked about how it's time to talk. We talked about many topics that go along with sexual health, i.e. consent. Not being afraid to say no. Because, yeah, exactly. You didn't say no last night. You passed out last night. Just falling asleep.
I love it.
Just falling asleep. Dale, it's so good to see you. We haven't seen you. But it's all of those things that lead into sexual health. Because in order to have sexual health, you have to understand what sexuality is. You got to get along with your partner. I'm going to say it. I believe it starts with yourself. If you don't have confidence in yourself, if you don't feel good about yourself, sexual health or any kind of health is going to be difficult to achieve. Because, let me back up. Part of sexual health is having a positive body image. Sadly, we've seen a lot of shaming go on over the years. You and I believe in faming, not shaming. You and I get asked, well, what do you find attractive? And we often say, well, yes, love may be blind, but attraction isn't. So, right.
I agree.
Be your own person. Be your own self. And be willing to accept and own who you are and what you are. Right. Kardashians. Change your looks, change your face. But again, if they're doing it, they're doing that for themselves. You did your breast. Body image is the way you see yourself and imagine how you look. So sometimes people forget what body image really means. That's what it means. And having a positive body image, to me, means that most of the time you see yourself accurately in the sense that you feel comfortable in your own body. So at the Sexual Health Expo, one of the big things I feel should be talked about, and I haven't looked at the schedule. I mean, they've got some interesting things on the schedule here. I don't know why sex positive TV, I mean, it'd be good, but the person they have doing it, I'm shocked. That's just my opinion. That's my opinion. I don't think the person's had a creative thought in about 10 years, but that's my opinion.
You know, I don't know if you want to add your
opinion. I'm controversial. Body image goes along with sexual healthiness. Because,
it starts with me.
Well, change. Right. If you want to eat better, eat better. Right. And it's not about, when you said change, it's not about changing it for other people. Do what you do for yourself. Right.
Yep.
We went gluten-free, just, I love your shirt, orgasm expert. Are you truly an orgasm expert for yourself or for others? I'm curious about this.
Yeah, so I teach orgasm
music
on one
table. Okay.
That
basically. So he does get off. Okay, so he gets off.
mentally more so than physically. He does get off physically. Interesting. So I know you can't hear this on Facebook Live. Thousands of you watching. What she's saying is, it's an orgasm different than what we're normally experiencing. It's putting your finger, in a way, on that button, right? You now have your finger on the button, and you're deciding how to, when to, if to, push that button. And it's an orgasm in a way that you're not used to take you to levels that are physical and mental. Would that be fair? Spiritually, like, you should see her and she's what she's doing to push these buttons. I'm getting a wreck right now. Okay, now where can people find you online if they want to learn more about you? We're going to find out now where you can find online if you want to know more. One Taste. So onetaste.us. I just love your shirt. Where can I get one of those?
You know, you got to earn the shirt.
I got to earn it?
Yeah, I've been away for 6 years. I got to practice.
I'm thinking I've got enough people that can vouch for me that I'm good at orgasms. I don't think I'm an expert yet, so I'll keep practicing. What? Why did I like to bring into orgasms? I wanted referrals. I've always been in open relationships. We're in an open relationship, my wife and I. So for me, it was about referrals.
That's what it is. Word of mouth.
Word of mouth, right? And I'm going to have to learn to take these orgasm meditation questions. Meditate. Getting orgasms. You are amazing. Thank you for letting us trouble you. And we need your shirt. Can we show your shirt real quick? Look at this beautiful lady. She is an orgasm expert. OneTaste.us. OneTaste.us.
Thank
I appreciate
you.
Thank you. Label Radio. I am Michael.
I'm Leah.
Leah, very nice to meet you. I kind of want to challenge her. Well, Mario, what do you think? I mean, I won't challenge her. She says she's an orgasm expert. It's one of those actions speak louder than words.
She was here.
Right.
And I had an orgasm.
All right. We just got it. This man I've known for a long time, and I trust him with my life and my wife and my family. So if he says it's true, it's true.
I think I'm
good. Good job. You rock, man. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. That was awesome. Mo, what's up? What's up, Mo? Yes, Michelle, we love that. Yeah, there you go. Thank you, Leah. We appreciate your time. We love being here at She. People are saying hi to you, Mario, Mo Green, and other people.
I'm all saying hi to Mo.
Yes, everybody wants to make sure to say hi. I mean, it's a big family. So we're talking about body image. Orgasming alone, orgasming with someone else, does help with our own natural feeling. Hi, Martha, you're very pretty. Just thought I'd tell you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm flirty girl. You should come.
You're what?
I'm flirty girl.
Flirty girl. All right. Well, you should come talk to us in a minute.
Yeah.
Playboy Radio.
Radio.
I am Michael. I'll do one of these.
I love it.
Well, kiss.
I'm flirty. Okay. I know what that means.
I like that.
I like it.
I like that. I do like that. Probably not. I mean, these beautiful women could say, hey, I want to go to bed with you. I think they meant sleep. I would still think they meant they wanted to sleep. I am so clueless when it comes to that. Absolutely clueless. But people with a positive body image also understand that how they look does not determine their self-worth. It doesn't. I agree. For you. I said this to my ex-wife because she wanted to get her breasts enlarged, and I would have said the same thing to you. Do you remember? Well, what did I say? Do you remember what I said, though? I'm sure that. Do you remember what I said when she asked my opinion? Exactly. If you're doing this for you and the way you feel, okay, but if you're doing it because you think it's what I want these to be. But one of the things I love about Desire is that people with all different types of bodies feel safe when there. Now, they walk in, they may be a little nervous. We got a message on social media from, we call family, not fans, we call family, because blood may make you related, but it's the loyalty that makes us all family. And, yeah, the ones you do like this with. And they said, we were really nervous once we got to Desire. We've heard all the great things from you and Michael, they were talking to you, and all this. But then we walk into our room, we see the two of you on our TV talking about it, we knew right away this was where we wanted to be. They started slowly removing their tops and their bottoms, and they felt at home and they understood why. But it does go back to body image. Don't worry about other things and what other people think. You do what feels right for you. Do it for you. Ask yourself this. You want to do, she is very pretty last night.
Find out where that photo came from. I'm okay with you doing that.
He's actually pretty cute. I'm straight, but I gotta tell you, he's pretty. He's
yeah, she's hot. Absolutely.
I don't want, you know, we'll get off body image in a second. It's just ask yourself, when you look in the mirror, how do you feel? Right? You see pictures in magazines, do you recognize a lot of Photoshop where people have done work? Don't compare yourself to others, because you just be the best you that you can be, boom, people will love you, and if they don't, it's their loss. That's how I look at it. Work. Exactly. Yeah, long time no see, guys. That's, you don't want to go that way with it, because when you do, you're right. Then the experiences can be very negative. Experiences can be unhealthy. Right. You're doing it for what they want, and don't do it for what they want. Do it, like you said, baby, like I said, because it feels good for you. What's your favorite thing to do? Compliment yourself on your own body. Yeah, sleep. I know. Sleep is your favorite thing to do. But when you have body image issues, instead of letting them take over you, what is it that you look in the mirror, maybe you do or don't like? Focus on what you do. Right. Focus, emphasize, stress. Highlight it if you like your breasts, if you like your butt, if you like your hips. I don't, the race, I don't care. I literally don't care race, gender, sexual orientation, ethnicity, religion, none of that. What I care about, do you feel good about you? Even if you're worried about your health, do you still feel good about you? Do something about it. That's it. Right. And hollyandmichael@gmail.com will give you suggestions. Sexual health experts, come to one. Listen to what they talk about. You don't necessarily need a hands-on class to do a blowjob, or a hands-on class to stroke a cock, or have a finger a pussy, or eat a pussy better. You don't always need that. But it does, some of the things, and what you and I talk about too, being strong, a secure me creates a strong. That's really what I feel about it. You were small-breasted, but beautiful, right? Right. Can you both talk now? It's just people saying they can't hear you, and then they can hear you.
But no one else. So right.
24/7, you live with you. So your body image, you decided at that point, the body image you decided to have was going to be positive because you're the best you could be. Right. I love that. I absolutely love that. I feel it's a strong attribute that shows the security you have in yourself and how you feel about yourself. And nothing... Fuck them. I say fuck them. We're talking about sexual health, and one of the benefits to sexual health, I think, is masturbation and usual masturbation. What causes people to get embarrassed? We're talking, hey guys, what causes people to get embarrassed when you ask, hey, do you masturbate? We're just talking about masturbation. Right? I may be one of the few. I may be one of the few that don't masturbate, and that's we can psychoanalyze me, all my degrees, my new PhD, all that. We can psychoanalyze me, but no. What? Psycho being the first word, absolutely. I'm going to ask you guys here, and I'll be talking to people to hear you, so talk just a little harder. You don't have to be louder. You don't have to be on camera. If somebody, if you're in a relationship or you're out with your friends, but you're like, what's the big reason behind people getting embarrassed when masturbation is the topic? Religion. So you believe religion, 100%. Grew up Mormon, wasn't allowed to touch yourself. So what did religion teach you? If you think religion, what do you think religion taught you or teaches others that needs to be untaught? So sexuality is something that's positive, sex positive, and it's not negative. And if you don't know your own body, I'm paraphrasing this beautifully, what I'm saying. If you don't know your own body, how can someone else? If you're not comfortable with your own body, how will you be comfortable with others? And if you're not willing to allow your body to express itself, aren't you missing out on, if you're religious, with God, if you believe in that, created for you and your body? Most definitely the beautiful lady's body. Sure, what do you say? Guys get embarrassed sometimes, you know, oh, did you jerk off today? Dude, don't talk about that. What do you think? Right.
Right.
So, about a question. Yeah. So, what a handsome gentleman is saying here, listen, I'm straight, but I can tell you, you're a really good looking man. You're a beautiful lady, you're a good looking man. What he's saying is that not all guys jerk off. When they do, they want it to be understood that it's for pleasure. It's not, oh, I see a hot girl. Oh, I see a hot girl. And then when you are doing it with your partner, now, it's, yes, it's still touching yourself. However, for sexual health reasons and erotic reasons, how much do you love?
I love
mutual masturbation.
It was until I asked you to do it. So, try it. It was amazing.
Yep. And funny here, Rio UGA is saying he masturbates more when he's having regular sex. But when he's not, because his libido. Listen, libido is like a muscle. I really believe libido, research shows, as an expert, I'm going to tell you this, libido is like a muscle. The more you use it, the more you exercise it, the stronger it gets. If you forget to exercise your libido, whether it is masturbating, whether it is making love or having sex or fucking, because that can be passionate into it too, you lose. It decreases. It's not necessarily hormonal, right? It's a muscle. It's a muscle. Your libido, I'm not talking penis and vaginas, okay? Talking libido. You guys agree? You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for joining us and for allowing us
into the podcast.
Well, that's a great show. It's actually live radio. This is Playboy Radio. We are Holly and Michael. Monday through Friday, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern on the Dash Radio. So you can download. It's free to listen, commercial free, all free, free, free. What are they saying? It's free!
It's free to move.
Download the app. Sam Phillips, she's with Vivid, actually. So they used to be with Playboy when we were all on SiriusXM. Sam's wonderful, beautiful woman. Very nice to meet you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you guys for talking to us about masturbation. Truly a pleasure. Truly a pleasure. I go back to it. You've always enjoyed masturbating. When you talk to people, when they understand that masturbating is healthy.
It's very healthy. If you don't masturbate, you don't know your body. How are you supposed to tell if
right.
you're not masturbating?
Right.
Like, I know it feels good when you're in New York. I mean, you can tell them obviously what's good, but you don't know what to do. It's like, it's a lot of mental.
You're right. I was talking about penis strength the other day on air, if you remember last week, and this is one of the ways to strengthen your penis, is bring yourself, not to the point of climax, but get yourself there, train yourself to get there, and hold it, resist, don't orgasm right away. He does. He decided that once he comes, he's tired, and he's tired then. Yeah. I love seeing all these people walk up learning about Desire. They're signing up for the Desire Venice Cruise. This is an everything optional type of environment. Do you have to be a souvenir? No. Women or men, do you have to be bisexual? No. Do you have to be naked? No. Do you have to watch others have sex? No. Why, let others watch you? No. No, 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 no.
We hope you're open-minded.
That's it. Sex positive, open-minded. All of that could be yeses, but the fact is you don't have to feel bound by somebody else's stereotype or rule. That's the incredible thing about Desire Revere Maya and Desire Pearl Revere Maya and Desire Venture. I love it. It makes me happy. Yeah, at the end of September, I think we leave the 22nd, we get back October 3rd, or 24th, get back October 3rd. I'll test Mark. I know he's got it over there. He's got it over there. It's just amazing. So body image, very important to sexual health. Touching, pleasuring yourself, doing it with your partner, very important. Muscle, think that way. Your libido is like a muscle. Train the fuck out of your muscle. You know, listen, say, hey, a sexual relationship health expert said I should masturbate more. So I'm masturbating more. Well, your partner, exactly. You don't want it to interfere with your partner. You don't want it to be taking over. Don't let it take away from what the intimacy you and your partner have. But like Brent is saying, he uses it as a way to strengthen that muscle. So when he and Danny want to go, they go. Where's Flirty Girl? We're going to talk to Flirty Girl. Come here a second, Flirty Girl. I know. Do you mind putting on those headphones?
No.
All right.
Do you mind if I sit in the chair?
No, I'm going to give you a chair, actually, because I prefer standing on. Here, you want to sit over here so they can see you?
Yeah.
Here we go. Why don't you sit right here, and they can see you on Facebook Live there.
I love it.
Okay. So we're broadcasting, we're simulcasting on ours and Pink Radio.
Yeah.
A million people. So, just a few. And live radio, dash, 2 hours of Pink Radio. Now, Brooke, tell us who you are, where you come from, what you do.
Right.
Yep.
First
Absolutely.
And I'm not sure.
I love
and
that.
And I
yep.
really, much more able to finance if I'm connected.
Do,
if
your,
I feel taken
do your clients share with you, and again, men, we're guilty of this, let's not lie to ourselves, do they feel underappreciated,
yes.
not desired, and not wanted by their partners?
Nobody's happy about it,
there's a huge
desire
about it. I agree. Talk about it. I agree.
Like, they're just me, and not to stereotype, but men typically have a higher libido. And here's the thing, we talk a lot about that, and they need to be lifted up.
Right.
Absolutely. I really think that.
Nothing wrong with encouraging your man through compliments and power.
Absolutely not. I actually, the reason why I can use flirty girls is because I think flirting is hard.
Absolutely.
You need to date them.
Like, I absolutely agree.
Send them tests that say, like, you can't touch your back. Like,
yeah. Not finger,
but
touch. Yeah,
yeah.
touch.
Yeah.
I don't want to finger
in
there.
Like
a finger. Yeah, I'm not a peek in the sink guy.
You don't?
No,
I've had
a prostate exam when I was younger.
Oh, come on.
And I have a friend, very close friend, 6'9", 2'9", wait, how tall? Yeah, 6'9", 2'9".
Yeah.
He loves it. He says, Mikey. No, see, I'm not scared. I have good orgasms, and I don't like it. There, stereo. Stereo, yeah. I'm willing to try something younger because I'm putting it in my mouth, not my ass. I've got nothing against people who do. Nothing against. But I would have a color woman. I would believe in freedom of choice. That's it, I'm pro choice. She's had them. The only problem with pockets when she's had those is she feels like she's going to urinate. That's fine.
Yeah, I don't like that feeling.
She doesn't like that feeling.
Okay, do you have a squirt? I try not to.
I can get her squirt in certain positions, but she gets uncomfortable, so I don't go out of my way to get her to squirt because I respect that it doesn't make perfect.
Right. I know. I'm on a mission to squirt. I do not squirt. I don't actually
it's a relaxation. It really is.
You have to relax. I do. I know.
Yes, the difference is, though, it's harder to do. And if a man tells you, I can make every woman squirt, we had a guy do that at season one of our show.
I know.
Swore he could make any woman squirt. Guess how many women that season he made squirt?
Zero.
You got it. Zero.
Zero.
The minute you start bragging you can make any person squirt, we all know you can't do what you say.
But I think it's the new notch on the
like, possible.
Guys are out there being like,
I think it's hot when they do. I'm not sure that my way to get you to squirt. Because I think there's other things, like you said, the exploration. I love exploring Holly's body. When we invite others into the bedroom with us, I love exploring that woman's body and Holly's body. And it's the touching, it's the feeling, it's the kissing. It's like you said, appreciating them in bed and out of bed. Yep. Well, you're giving us that power. I mean, let's back up. You are giving us that power, which is sweet, but you can also take that power back if the man doesn't respect the power you give.
Absolutely.
Right.
And that's what 34 does.
Okay, I love
that. Understand.
Yes. Yes. Because we're back. Yep. And I say, just take it off. No, I'm kidding. I agree. Tell a flirty girl what I've always said to you. What I tell her. All I'm thinking is I want this to last. I'm on a pleasure now. I have admitted. Being married to pockets, I'm not worried about referrals. I'm a single, always open. I enjoy it. She doesn't speak very highly of me sexually. I'm working on it. It's a practice, right? When I'm single, I would, you know, had you care about referrals. Yes, I hope she had a good time, but I'm not responsible. You are responsible to relax. You are responsible. I hope you have. But if you had a good time, I'm hoping you tell your friends and they want to experience it too. So it does. I believe it starts top side of the bed. Whether you're single, you're dating.
roses are going way up in price. Just pay him a compliment, and you won't pay $100 for roses.
I will spread my legs.
Tell me about your day.
Let's see.
So how can people find the flirting?
I agree, and that's one of the things that I take great pride in doing. I believe a secure me creates a strong me. And I believe there are a lot of people, and they do good, they can talk about how to get better head, or how to eat vagina better. They can talk about Kama Sutra in different positions. But if you're not secure with yourself, and you're not secure in your relationship, and your partner isn't providing you, you don't feel you need to exercise that muscle I call leaving.
It is a muscle. If you don't exercise it,
right. That's how she compares sex at the gym. She says, I don't want to go, but once I'm done, I feel good.
Right. She's still hoping to have good sex.
I know.
Or she's still hoping.
I'm getting
not by the process. But I do, I work hard. I train at it. I'm listening to you.
Thank you. What did Yoda say? Do or do not, there is no try. Being a flirty girl, I feel this is an appropriate question to ask. What is with society now and manners? Because I have seen men be polite, but it be mistaken for flirting. Flirting is, I agree, flirting does not have to be about sex, right? Like, oh, he wants to have sex with me, so I can't talk to him. Right, exactly. Oh, they want to have sex with us. No, we don't. No, there's a lot of people we don't want to have sex with. Right. And I say love is boring, but attraction isn't.
No.
So there are different things that come into play. And when I give a woman, this is a beautiful woman right here, it does not mean though that I want to have sex. Well, but it doesn't mean that I want to have sex. I can give a compliment and not mean it. Hey, let's go to bed. Now, she said, if you go to bed,
she says she's open.
She's
open and willing.
She's willing? Okay. Open and willing? Okay.
Well, I
mean, that's one out of millions to say that.
That's what I'm saying. Just because I pay a compliment to somebody, I'm a straight man. I'll take it.
Mario's a good friend.
If they're confident, they do. And they understand I'm not trying to get anything from them. You know?
Women starving themselves at times.
So a woman's worst enemy can't be herself. I agree.
Body image. Go back to body image. Yep. Exactly.
We do. I think you have breasts.
Listen, I'm naked. Things are sagging. Things are sagging at me. You, I want them. I want to look at them. Oh my God, I look and the lips, and I love it. I see me naked. I'm like, hey, I like my ass, but the rest, let's just get rid of the rest.
Right? Oh. Oh yeah. No, not at all. Not at all. No. As long as I'm playing with them, and there's not milk coming out right now. Some guys do. I'll go get my cholesterol in a supplement. I don't need to go direct to the source. Fresh and easy. But I do like fresh. I do like things that are fresh. I do like women that are easy. So you guys are definitely going down the path I want. You're definitely going down the path. No preservatives. Only latex free kind. Women need to give it away. Yeah, okay, use women. I agree.
already have some body conscious bodies, right? When you walk in and you see people of all shapes and sizes, all races, all ethnicities, all cultures that you never expected to see, and you recognize that when we're all naked, we're all the same. Because it goes back to the one saying, say hello. If the world was blind, how many people would you really impress? Because all you have is what's in your heart. When you're naked, it doesn't matter what brand watch you wear, what tags on my shirt or my shoes. It's you. It's me. It's you. It's you. That's the event. That's what we desire. If you want to be naked, you can. If you want to be top surgical, you can take that. If you want to be in a position, no one's going to judge you. These are people that become confident after being at a desire. These are people that are confident before being desired. These are people that aren't sure what the desire, Riviera Maya, desire, Riviera Maya, desire ministry, desire ministry, to Rome Cruise. I feel their minds because we see it. We're there, Mario, what, 4 to 6 times a year, we're with you guys broadcasting speaking of desire. It's, listen. Yep, there you go. Last month. Second, lost both breasts. That's it. It's sex positivity. It's open-minded. It's people saying, look how beautiful you are. She had some consciousness about after her hips are not yet. She wore body jewelry. Gorgeous body jewelry. Had no clue. No clue. You would not have been able to tell. But she said on air. But one of the things I say is, we forget about the caregiver. Her husband's been doing the whole thing. And what kind of kindness and love he deserves, too, for doing that. And then, the just pat on the back she deserves, like you said, the confidence to go to their pockets, to be willing to experience that. Mario, you know that stuff happens, right? People come to your events, to your patients, and they begin to feel empowered by not just your staff, but by the rest of the guests.
So at 13, she had her first telephone call with the boy.
And her father hung up on the boy and yelled at
her. That would cause fear.
Yes.
So you've been waiting for your parents' permission to be a sexual woman.
For my
woman.
Father's permission.
For your father's permission.
Yeah, yes. And I'm excited.
Good for you. Good for you. And you said this earlier before you came on that unfortunately masturbation is a taboo topic for some people. Pockets growing up Mormon, they weren't allowed to masturbate. It's against their church. When you hear the word masturbation, at a point in life now, do you understand that's okay? Masturbation is part of growing up. Yeah. A sex therapist, but she's living proof of what happens. People don't know their bodies. That's what Flirty Girl does. Flirty Girl teaches.
I tell all my girls the same opposite. Do not bring
about her sexuality, how sexy she feels. But her father, unfortunately, told her that sexuality and sensuality was wrong.
So she had to get out from underneath that verbal thought and that emotional thought, and recognize what a gorgeous woman she is, how beautiful she is, and that it's okay to own her own body, her own sexuality. And now men are coming out of the woodworks. Like never before, men are approaching her and desiring her, and she desires herself too. Right. Parents don't have to know either. It's your life.
Yeah, and yep. Of course, we all know they did the best they could. What they did, and they did to me, what was done to them. There's all of that, but what am I going to get out of talking to them?
Nothing.
Nothing good. Nothing good. Boundaries are good.
I know they're sexual beings, but...
Pockets asked if she thinks her parents are sexual beings. She said, yes, they're sexual beings, but as their kid, they don't think of me that way. Unfortunately, that happens a lot.
All
I know it's hard to hear, but they're talking about her sexuality, how she feels about herself, the changes, the evolution she's gone through at 45 years old. Pockets is talking about if you don't teach, no sex education is sex education, because if you don't teach children of any age when they ask, remember you answer the question of where I came from a 3-year-old, all you have to do is say mommy's tummy. But a 13-year-old is asking a different question. So make sure you answer age appropriate. This will replay Tuesday of this week on Dash Radio. Download the app for free. Android or iOS devices. You can also go to dashradio.com/Playboy Radio. Modern love, Holly and Michael. We're not done yet, though. So you asked your dad why he didn't talk to you.
I didn't even ask him. I just mentioned.
You just mentioned. Sorry, Brooke. You just mentioned, hey, Dad, why didn't you share these things with me about sexual education?
I didn't ask. I just told him.
Okay. And what did he say? What did he say when you asked?
I know my father. My father is not going to have a conversation about why he didn't do certain things as a father. He was a great provider and all of that. Just like, you know, give him his props. But I just said to him one day, I just really believe things would have been different had you sat us down and talked to me.
Did you grow up in a religious household? Or
yes.
Was it just very, okay.
Yes, it was religious, Baptist. Okay. My parents were in rural Mississippi, raised me in Michigan.
Do you think churches need to educate the people in the church that sex and that's how you make babies?
And I understand religion. I do volunteer missionary work in Ghana, in West Africa. There's always this power struggle between the religious side and the, well, others are religious, but safe sex side.
Right.
And they're saying, well, preach, teach, show abstinence. And I say, listen, I don't disagree. Let's try for abstinence. But if that doesn't work, especially in the tribes, like out of the bush, where they have no electronics, they might have one basketball and one net. That's it. I'm not kidding.
what else do they do when their libido goes crazy? So why don't we help prevent HIV? Why don't we help prevent other STDs and STIs? Why don't we help prevent unwanted pregnancies and allow them to use, I believe latex spray is the best way to go, because some of you ladies don't know you have latex allergies. Guys use latex spray. But we'll give them condoms and let them make the decision. That's a way of saying, hey, not half sex. That spoon doesn't tell you to eat the ice cream. I decide to eat the ice cream. You know, well, that's what I say the same thing. Okay, I don't want to debate. What about guns kill people? No, people kill people. Just like spoons cause me to eat too much ice cream. That's why I'm not looking at gun control.
Pencil made a mistake.
Pencil made a mistake. I didn't miss that question on the test teacher. Pencil made a mistake. You know? Should I tip an LOL after everything?
I know, right?
You are amazing. Thank you so much for joining us here on Playboy Radio with Holly and Michael. You are amazing. Can I kiss the cheek again? You are a beautiful woman. Amazing. I am to my wife.
Oh,
we're in an open relationship. We fly in the room again. She's a boss. I'm a smart man. I let the woman lead.
Smart man.
What do you think, bro?
Smart man. I'm a mom.
Right?
I'm a mom of really young girls. I'm really young girls.
Kids, because I go back to the kids ask a question. At 3 years old, where do I come from? Mommy's tummy. Great.
Yeah.
They didn't ask how was I made.
That's right.
Don't
That's
answer right. the question that wasn't asked.
That's
answer
right.
that question. So when our children have asked us about coitus, they call it coitus because of Big Bang Theory, what is it we want to know? At 8, they had different questions than now at 14.
I have a 7-year-old.
You have a 7-year-old, so you understand. Playboy Radio's Holly and Michael, live Monday through Friday, 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern. Always, always check Dash Radio. Download the app for free on iOS and Android devices. Or go to playboyradio.com/playboyradio. That's what it is. You are the flirtygirlguide.com. And on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, the Flirty Girl Guide.
Yes,
there we go.
Cheerleader for women everywhere.
I have to agree with her because I've just been surrounded by amazing women. I've got Mario here representing Desire. We, as you know, are proud to represent Desire. That is our home. Here is our second home. This is our home. Why do I say that? Because, and I'm not even getting paid to be here today, by the way. We did this because of the love that we believe so strongly in Desire and their experiences at the resorts and the cruises, that when we knew Mario was going to be here, yeah, we're selfish. We wanted to see Mario. But we wanted to share with you, our family, the world, how amazing the Sexual Health Expo is and that Desire supports all types of sex positivity, sexual health, well-being for the all-around total person. You agree?
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Awesome.
We look forward to talking to you. We'll have to have you come in the studio and talk some more sometimes.
Yes.
Off the 101 if I ain't going
yes.
to do that. Pockets, I love when we get to spend time on live stream. I love when we get to spend time on location and meet amazing people. Here we are. Crap, we're at the end of the show. So much I wanted to talk about. I'm glad Mario got to talk a little. Anything we missed? Are you ready? Swing, swing. We love you, family. We're sorry. Some of it may have been hard to hear. We know that. But that's one of the things coming on location. We're going to get a different microphone so you can hear Holly and I. We'll pin it here so it'll be easier. But thank you so much for staying with us. Hold on. Oh, sure.
Bye.
Bye. Mario, you want to say anything before we sign off?
While you were interviewing these people, let me tell you, I just had a talk with the head doctor. She claims to be the best person ever to give head.
To give head?
Yeah.
Oh, she was the head doctor.
Yeah, she's
oh, I thought she was a head doctor. Okay.
Head doctor.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, so she wanted to do a thing with me and I said, no, please, I'm working. So, you know.
She wanted to show you that
yeah,
she's
yeah,
the best.
Always professional. Always professional. Always. And that's why I was starting to get your
always
attention. Maybe I'm like, you know somebody who can help you. Thank you for watching.
There you go.
Mario is a much stronger man than I am. If Fox had given me permission, I'd have gone right back in that booth there. Why not, right? I don't know. We love you guys.
Peace out, everybody.